Welcome to the Health Room, your health and wellness authority. Are you planning on taking probiotic supplements or currently taking it now? In this video, you will discover the reasons why you should think twice before consuming probiotic supplements. Probiotics are living bacteria and yeasts that provide health benefits when consumed in large amounts. They can be taken as supplements or consumed naturally through fermented foods like yogurt, kefir, sauerkraut, kimchi, and kombucha. The health benefits of probiotic supplements and foods have been well documented, including a lower risk of infections, improved digestion, and even a reduced risk for some chronic diseases. While there are many health benefits linked to taking probiotics, there can also be side effects. For some people with serious illnesses or compromised immune systems, probiotics may cause complications than bring good health. If you are new to this channel, please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button to keep you notified and updated with our latest videos. We are trying our best to give you the most informative health-related videos regularly. That being said, here are the dangers of taking probiotics you may not be aware yet. 1. Skin problems. In a lot of cases, probiotics may cause skin rashes or itchiness. Authors of a 2018 review found that two study participants who took probiotics to treat IBS reported an itchy rash as a side effect. This led one participant to drop out of the trial. If a rash or severe itching occurs, stop using the probiotic. Check the product's labeling for any possible allergens, and see a doctor if the rash is severe, persistent, or it accompanies other concerning symptoms. 2. It can cause headaches. Some probiotic-rich foods, like yogurt, sauerkraut, and kimchi, contain biogenic amines. Biogenic amines are substances that form when protein-containing foods age or are fermented by bacteria. The most common amines found in probiotic-rich foods include histamine, tyramine, tryptamine, and phenylethylamine. Amines can excite the central nervous system, increase or decrease blood flow, and may trigger headaches in people sensitive to the substance. One study found that low histamine diets reduced headaches in 75% of participants. However, a review of 10 controlled studies found no significant effect of dietary amines on headaches. More research is needed to determine whether or not amines can be direct triggers of headaches or migraines in some people. Keeping a food diary, including any headache symptoms you might experience, can help clarify whether fermented foods are problematic for you. 3. Some ingredients may cause adverse reactions. People with allergies or intolerances should read the labels of probiotic supplements carefully, since they might contain ingredients they could react to. For example, some of the supplements contain allergens such as dairy, egg, or soy. These ingredients should be avoided by anyone who is allergic, as they may trigger an allergic reaction. If necessary, read labels carefully to avoid these ingredients. Similarly, yeast-based probiotics should not be taken by those with yeast allergies. Milk sugar, or lactose, is also used in many probiotic supplements. While studies suggest that most people with lactose intolerance can tolerate up to 400 mg of lactose in medications or supplements, there have been case reports of adverse effects from probiotics. In addition to containing powerful probiotics, some supplements also contain prebiotics. These are plant fibers that humans cannot digest, but that bacteria can consume as food. The most common types are lactulose, inulin, and various oligosaccharides. When a supplement contains both probiotic microorganisms and prebiotic fibers, it is called a symbiotic. Some people experience gas and bloating when consuming symbiotics. Those who experience these side effects may want to select a supplement that does not contain prebiotics. 4. Allergy symptoms. If you develop allergy-like symptoms after you start taking probiotics, don't stress. It doesn't necessarily mean you're allergic to them, you might just be sensitive to histamines. In some people, certain strains of bacteria can increase histamine levels in the GI tract, so the body reacts the same way it would to an allergen. Too much histamine and you might end up with a runny nose, itchy eyes, or shortness of breath. 5. Bloating. Bloating is the most common side effect with many forms of digestive distress. It occurs when your abdomen fills with excess air or gas. Your stomach may look large or swollen and feel tight to the touch. While it's generally not fatal, bloating can come with plenty of pain and discomfort. 6. Gas. Gas and bloating often go hand in hand. The digestive process itself normally produces gas. The average person passes gas 13 to 21 times per day. Gas in your GI tract comes from air that you swallow or by the breakdown of undigested foods by bacteria in your colon or large intestine. Normally, as bacteria digest food in your gut, gas is released. Certain foods, particularly those high in fiber, cause more gas production than others. Probiotic supplements essentially provide your gut with more of the good digestive bacteria. Overdosing on that bacteria can cause increased gas, which also means more bloating. 7. It can increase histamine levels. Some bacterial strains used in probiotic supplements can produce histamine inside the digestive tract of humans. Histamine is a molecule that is normally produced by your immune system when it detects a threat. When histamine levels rise, blood vessels dilate to bring more blood to the affected area. The vessels also become more permeable so that immune cells can easily get into the relevant tissue to combat any pathogens. This process creates redness and swelling in the affected area, and can also trigger allergy symptoms such as itching, watery eyes, runny nose, or trouble breathing. Normally, histamine that is produced in your digestive tract is naturally degraded by an enzyme called diamine oxidase, DAO. This enzyme inhibits histamine levels from rising enough to cause symptoms. However, some people with histamine intolerance have trouble properly breaking down the histamine in their bodies, seeing as they do not produce enough DAO. 8. It can cause diarrhea. Diarrhea is characterized by loose, watery bowel movements that may happen more frequently. Diarrhea may also be accompanied by general abdominal pain, bloating, and nausea. Acute diarrhea lasts only about a day or two and goes away on its own. It is usually caused by food or water that has been contaminated by harmful bacteria, viruses, or parasites. Diarrhea that lasts longer can point to a more serious underlying problem. Probiotics such as Lactobacillus acidophilus and Saccharomyces boulardii have been found to reduce the duration of diarrhea. However, overdosing on probiotics can irritate your gut and result in loose stools. 9. It can increase infection risk. Probiotics are safe for the vast majority of the population, but may not be the best fit for everyone. In rare cases, the bacteria or yeasts found in probiotics can enter the bloodstream and cause infections in susceptible individuals. Those at greatest risk for infection from probiotics include people with suppressed immune systems, prolonged hospitalizations, venous catheters, or those who have undergone recent surgeries. It is estimated that only about 1 in 1 million people who take probiotics containing lactobacilli bacteria will develop an infection. The risk is smaller for yeast-based probiotics, with only about 1 in 5.6 million users getting infected. 10. Abdominal pain. All of the above symptoms can contribute to general abdominal pains, which can be exhibited as sharp pains, cramps, or tightness. By now you should be more aware of the potential dangers of taking probiotic supplements. If you continue to have discomfort while taking probiotics, it is recommended for you to stop. Because of the differences in dose, diversity, and delivery mechanisms, not all probiotics are created equal. One probiotic will not have the same benefits or side effects as another. For example, a probiotic using one strain of Lactobacillus acidophilus may help your digestive health, but another using a different Lactobacillus rhamnosus strain may not have the same effect. Do you know any other adverse effects of taking probiotics? If you do, please share it in the comments section down below. This way, you are able to help others who are also looking for more information on this subject. Make sure to like or share this video with your friends to inform them as well. Please also watch our other health videos to help this channel grow and reach a wider audience. Thanks for watching, The Health Room.